you walk into my studio, you are in the kitchen. I keep my kitchen pretty tidy. I try anyway, especially because the space is so small. It's just nice if everything looks clean and fresh. My favorite thing in the kitchen is the coffee machine. It is such a game changer. I spend a lot less money on takeout coffee, and I just love having a coffee in the morning. On your right hand side when you walk in, there is the bathroom and the toilet. I'm planning on decorating this whole door with pictures at one point. Yeah, the kitchen is pretty minimalistic and simple, which is basically the style of my whole studio. I just have a small microwave oven and a little stove. I do really love my kitchen though. I have a small little table and I really just love having breakfast there. When I do groceries every week, I try to get fresh flowers, and if you have some fruit and flowers in your house, it doesn't matter how small or big your kitchen is, it just looks very put together. Then walking further into the studio, on the left hand side I have my dresser with my favorite jewelry put out, my skincare that I use on a daily basis, my makeup brushes, and just some things that I want to have handy. This gorgeous record player and the speaker behind it are from the brand House of Marley, and I actually got these of my parents for my birthday. I'm so happy about it, honestly, I love it so much. Right now I obviously took the cap off, but it actually has a little protective cloth you can put over it, so normally it doesn't look like this all the time. Obviously for the video I thought I would show you guys what it looks like. One of my favorite things in this small little space is the huge mirror I have over here. It is 2 meters tall. Just for reference, this is me in the mirror. This is honestly one of my favorite things about the room. It just gives it a lot more light and it makes it look a lot bigger. And then as you can see, my bed is just next to the window where you can see all the other dorms. The current setup I have is I have this little trolley, which is a little bit messy. I just mostly have filming equipment and like cables and things like that in here. I definitely need to organize that. And then here I just made a little plant stand. This gorgeous little one is actually not mine, it's my neighbor's, but I'm mining it for her for a little bit. And I'm not even gonna talk about that one, but yeah, that was a plant as well. In the windowsill we also have a couple of plants. I honestly want a lot more plants in my place. This was just a set of some mini cacti that I got. So yeah, they're okay, I guess. This one's definitely growing. The cat broke the top of this one, unfortunately, so that was about this tall, and now overnight she just teared that off somehow. This one has been having a really rough time. I'm not sure if he's gonna make it. The cat keeps pulling it out. And this little fella has just been chilling. I really love my little bed corner. I got this thing at IKEA for literally only 12 euro, and it's one of the best things I've bought in a while. I just love sitting on the bed and having the window next to me and doing any type of schoolwork or just anything I have to do on my laptop. This one I got in only last week, and if I'm really honest, I still haven't quite made up my mind about it. So first I had this little string of plants going over my bed, but I kind of was missing something in this little, like, as a centerpiece. So yeah, I have hung up this, but I'm actually not too sure. The colors are quite bright, and to be honest, it was a lot bigger than I expected it to be. I thought the whole thing was gonna be about this size, but for now I think I do like it. It kind of ties it all in together, and I do love some art on my walls. There's one thing I've definitely learned from living in studio apartments, but obviously I've also lived in hostels and anything, is that I just really love to have a place to myself, and it doesn't really matter how big it is, this little part right here is my favorite spot. I love having my coffee here. And yeah, I'm actually really happy about the situation right now. Then next to my bed, honestly, I've changed my room around so much lately, but I have this set of shelves. I got a Facebook Marketplace for only 7 euro. On my shelves, I have what is the start of my record collection. Right now, I have Carole King and Fleetwood Mac. I got these of my parents as well, together with my record player. I really can't wait to go thrift shopping and find some good records. Obviously, in lockdown now, that's not possible, but one day this will all be filled up with records. Then on this side, I have some of my books that I've recently read. I have finished these ones. This one I got of my friends for my birthday. I finished Ghost by Dolly Alderton as well, and these two I still need to read. And here I have a little wireless charger, which is really handy. I can just pop my phone on there. On the shelf closer to my bed, I just have my 6-minute journal, which I also got of my friends, the book I'm currently reading, Norwegian Wood by Haruki Murakami, and my journals. And on this side, my toothbrush is just charging. So currently my shoes are stacked away in these boxes I got from IKEA. I think for now this is how I'm going to leave it. These two didn't fit in anymore. I do think it just looks really nice and neatly stored away. Like, you can't really see that they're shoes. So for now I'll probably keep it like this. This bed I got from IKEA, and it has 4 really big drawers, which is very important if you have a small space. Any type of storage is very welcomed. So right next to the bed, I have this cute little couch. It is very small, but I just think it makes the studio look a little bit more homesy. And yeah, as I said, I've been moving around everything quite a lot, but for now, I think this is the setting I like best. So on the side of the couch, I have this really nice, you could say vintage, wooden crate. My parents used to have this in their house. These books were all actually gifts for my graduation. My mom asked everybody of my family to pick a book that meant something to them. I just think it's really cute, and the top of this I use kind of as a side table. I have my favorite candle on here right now. This is a candle from H&M Home, and it smells amazing. I've almost burned it out completely, as you can see, so I probably have to order a new one soon. And then I just have my yoga mat. As you can see, it has definitely been used quite a lot. So I just have these on the side, and I think I've had these two together in every place I've lived basically. I just always bring this along. And as you can see, the kitchen is over here. So the last thing I have in the corner of my sort of living area space is just a little desk setup right there. Hi! You're gonna show us your house? So next to the dresser in this corner, I have a little spot for the queen of the house, which is Naya. And yeah, it does take actually up quite some room. And it is a little bit too big for a small studio like mine, but honestly, she loves it so much, I could never take it away from her. So a little random thing is the floor in the studio. The studio actually comes with a different floor, but when I moved in, this girl in the hall was moving out, and I was able to buy it off her, as her room had the exact same dimensions. So I was really happy about that, because I think it just makes it look a lot more like an actual home. Then to end this video, I'll give you one more spin around my dorm here at AUC. I am very much in love with my studio. I'm really happy with how it looks at the moment. So I think this is probably what it will look like for the next while. I try to keep my room very minimalistic and simple, just because I feel like a calm space just helps me focus. And especially now in lockdown, it's just so important that you feel happy in your own space. And yeah, I definitely feel at home here. If you enjoyed my video, please make sure to like the video, and if you're not subscribed yet and you want to, make sure to subscribe to my channel, and I will see you in my next one.